Balenciaga under fire, their ad campaign featuring BDSM and children. As if those two things go together, a major fashion house is presenting this ad, teddy bears dressed in bondage with a toddler. Now, I don't understand it, but a lot of people are asking questions and a lot of people are demanding answers of celebrities too. I thought people were trolling, but nope, it's real. Maybe this is why Balenciaga left Twitter. They don't want to be held accountable. Yes, these are children holding teddy bears dressed in bondage outfits. Now, this photo shoot was part of Balenciaga's campaign to promote their new objects range. In addition to these images, Balenciaga also had a photo of one of their handbags, a collab with Adidas, sitting on top of court documents regarding virtual child porn. Okay, you see it right there. What do you say? Okay, one page mostly covered by the bag contains text of the Supreme Court case, United States versus Williams, a SCOTUS case concerning the distribution of child porn. David, the fashion house is now reacting, distancing themselves, has filed a $25 million lawsuit against the producers, the people behind this ad campaign. How are we to excuse them and how can they get away with this?
Yeah, I mean, at a certain point, and anybody who knows how advertising works, there was a certain, at some point there was a meeting between somebody from Balenciaga and this advertising agency, and they talked about concepts. And at a certain point, the concept was made into an ad, and somebody at Balenciaga had to have signed off on it. If somebody did not sign off on that, then okay, Balenciaga has a case, but that's not the real world of how these things tend to work. And so Balenciaga's got a huge crisis communications problem on their hands right now. Never mind the lawsuit. They should be taking their own steps to get to the bottom of this, to fire the people who are involved in this particular account. They should be making amends. They should be donating money to the groups that help victims of child abuse and child pornography. They can't just file a lawsuit and say, oh, we didn't know about this, because someone there did know about it. And the advertising firm, I want to know which advertising firm was involved in this production too, because they should be banned from ever producing ads again. Anybody who thinks that child pornography is worth sort of helping to promote or sell your goods, that is insane. If you want to be involved in BDSM or all that other stuff on your own time and leather and straps and all the other kind of, go for it. But there's no need, there's no reason to include the rest of us. And certainly there's no excuse for including children in that message.
Well said, and I want to double down on the lawsuit, David, because they are very specific and why they say Balenciaga, they are suing. The fashion house brought the suit Friday against production company North 6 Inc. Okay, so there's that. And set designer Nicholas Desjardins and his company for the inclusion in one of the ads of legal documents from a US Supreme Court decision on child porn laws. That's from the New York Post. Balenciaga claims North 6 and Desjardins included the images of the court documents without its knowledge. And they say that was, you know, at the very least, extraordinary, reckless, that the filing goes on to say. But what they don't mention are those bears dressed in bondage, David. So again, they seem desperate to get out of this, but they, you've taken us through the steps, the process of how this thing works. There's no getting around it. That is absolutely how an ad goes to press, particularly for one of the most famed fashion houses in the world. So how do they escape this?
Yeah, I don't know. And you raised, I mean, the key point here in all this is, you know, to me, even like the Supreme Court opinion, a document that was put in this, to me, that's not even as offensive. And it is offensive in terms of what it means. But the image of children with teddy bears and BDSM, that's to me, who could possibly think that that was appropriate or that was something that the fashion house should be involved in? They're not addressing that. Somebody needs to take responsibility for that aspect, even if they claim that they were hoodwinked on the document that was put in their ad, so be it. But this is a disaster. And you know, Balenciaga, they're gonna pay some consequences as a result, because I think so many people who are sickened by this are gonna say, we're never gonna buy anything from this company again.
Yeah, and you know, I think a lot of people are beyond or not inviting anymore of cancel culture, but there are certain things that perhaps do need to be canceled. And using children in this way and putting out ads about child porn, which clearly the intention was there, perhaps this is the time, if any time. The fashion house is apologizing And they said, this is after the criticism, of course, allegations of normalizing sexual fetishization and abuse of children. Balenciaga eventually pulled the ads and issued this statement. So here it is, we sincerely apologize for any offense our holiday campaign may have caused. Our plush bear bag should not have been featured with children in this campaign. We have immediately removed the campaign from all platforms. We apologize, goes on to say, for displaying unsettling documents in our campaign. We take this matter very seriously and are taking legal action against the parties responsible for creating the set and including unapproved items for our Spring 23 campaign photo shoot. We strongly condemn abuse of children in any form. We stand for children's safety and well-being. For any offense it may have caused, David, it doesn't go far enough. And what could you say, okay?
I mean, it does sound like that's a conditional apology. If you were insulted or if you thought that this was inappropriate, we are sorry to you. No, no, no. You should be apologizing from the front end saying what we did was wrong. We did not exercise responsibility over this. Maybe we were misled, but you know what? You take responsibility. You are the company that is paying for this advertising. It is on you. It's not just the production house. And until Balenciaga can sort of realize that they are the ones who need to take ownership of this and rectify it, not just through lawsuits, their problems are only going to get even deeper.
Yeah, and I haven't heard that anybody's been terminated. And I hate for anybody to lose a job, but I haven't heard that anybody.
Or have a call for an internal investigation. Here's what we're doing to find out who is responsible for this. And here's what's gonna happen when we find out who is responsible. They're not even doing that. They're just saying, oh no, we're just gonna sue this advertising agency for this one aspect of the ad. That's not good enough.
No, it's not. And neither is the father, one of the children in the ad saying that, you know what, my daughter had a great time. What's the big deal? I'm paraphrasing, but that's pretty much what was said there. Let's see, let's put up the statement from the father there defending it. And the daughter's inclusion, the girl was in a plush bear handbag collection shoot for the fashion brand. We showed you the picture, no need to see it again. But the British child model, the father says, listen, I'm defending the photo shoot again. My daughter had a fantastic time. Celebrities, David, are coming out and you know, celebrities love free swag. They love Balenciaga, Kim Kardashian among them, Bella Hadid, a top supermodel. People are calling on them to denounce this, to detach themselves permanently from Balenciaga. I want to put up what's being said and what Kim Kardashian is saying at this time. She's frequently collaborated with Balenciaga. She took to Instagram on Sunday to say she was disgusted and outraged by the campaign. Is that enough? She does say, David, that she's reevaluating her relationship. But anybody who follows the Kardashians, probably you more than me, knows that she loves Balenciaga.
Yeah, I think that's just sort of, I was sort of waiting for the other part of the statement. She was disgusted and outraged. And what are you gonna do about it? Mm-mm. I'm gonna stop buying Balenciaga for the time being while I figure out what really happened and wait to see what they do next. Or I'm gonna stop buying them for a period of time, or I'm gonna stop wearing it, I'm gonna stop promoting this, I'm gonna stop my association with them. But just saying you're disgusted and outraged, okay, I'm disgusted and outraged by a lot of things that are around me.
Yeah.
What am I doing to fix those things? That's the question.
Yeah, that's the question. She doesn't say any of that. And you know, furthermore, she took too long to even react to this, as even her own supporters were saying, come on, get out in front of this. And then she said she had a private conversation with executives because she needed to learn more about how this could have happened. She didn't share any of that. So stay tuned, we'll see if more celebrities come and speak out.